Hello, Virgo. Happy first reading, love reading, weekly love reading for the month of January. A new year, a new week, but a new decade. So let's look and see what the energy is. Virgo, this is a reading for the collective Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. You know the drill. If it isn't for you, it isn't for you. Don't try to make it fit. Don't be upset. All right, so the mutual energy, that was a fast shuffle, coming into this week in your love life, Virgo, is a Heart of Cups, and that's a Queen of Cups. So that shows that, you know, you're really feeling the person that you adore and you share a mutual love of one another. In the recent past, what was a mutual energy in the recent past? Aha! Great love. Wow. Very interesting, Virgo. Very interesting that great love. Lots of love here. Wow. You are feeling loved. You are loved. You love the other person. So how does your person, Virgo, see this going forward? What do they see as a situation with the two of you? Well, they see the two of you as having a chance for celebration this week. They see the two of you as hopefully getting together for a drink. They see that your person loves you as a friend, but also as an intimate partner. So very deep. Deep levels of love. You really wish the best for each other. That's a very beautiful kind of a love, because it says it's ego. It's less ego, right? Friendship love has less ego involved in it. How they view you, Virgo, how your partner views you as their future, their wish fulfillment, looking into the future. They want to travel the long road of knowing you and enjoying you. They see you as a planner and a builder and somebody who is always looking forward. How do they feel about you? Ooh, they're hiding wonderful feelings and desires to nurture you. The High Priestess says, I love you, but I'm going to keep it to myself. The High Priestess is very spiritual. As you can see, there's a Magician card here. There's manifestation. Your person loves you. There's this Venus energy. There's a Moon energy. There's taking action without really talking about the relationship a lot. You know, really holding you in their heart. You're constantly with them. They dream about you. They think about you. Really shows a very strong connection between the two of you. How do they see the situation moving forward? Well, they think masculine energy has to make a decision about love. Masculine energy, this is a King of Cups. That indicates that your person doesn't really know how you feel about them. Because the Moon card follows, it shows the underlying energy is that of confusion. You know, at night you can't see the truth as brightly as you can during the daytime. So there's this sort of obscurity. There's love here. There's great Piscean love. But it shows that the Moon is obscuring a clear view to that love. The advice of the tarot going forward this week is the Movement of Pentacles. Virgo, you showed up in your reading. You are the reliable, slow-moving, deliberate, action-oriented person. You always have a plan. You always make a plan. You always work your plan. You always stick to your plan. So in some ways, Virgo, you are not as spontaneous as the energy of your person. The person that you're with is much more intuitive about their emotions. They're much more, I would say, expressive about them. Your person has told you that they love you, and I don't think you have told them back. And so they wonder. They're left curious. All right. So let's look. You've given gestures of love, but you haven't really expressed your love in a very direct way. All right. The Movement of Wands says that the week will end with a passionate encounter. Ooh, that's exciting. The energy coming into the reading that's hidden under everything else is the Ace of Coins. There will be a new offer made. The Spirit of Pentacles is the King of Pentacles. That offer comes from the masculine entity in this relationship. This relationship has a lot of power, and this relationship is built on a very innocent level of trust, and you probably work together. I'm also seeing the energy here of the Sky Father. That's very airy energy. The Sky Father is the Emperor card. That is the Emperor card in this deck. It says, basically, Virgo, if you're the masculine energy, you're the Emperor. And it's coming up sort of as you are the masculine energy here. But anyway, so let's look at this. You have a plan. Ooh, look at you. Stealthy Virgo. You do have a plan. You just have not revealed that plan. All right. So an unusual amount of underlying energy, but the story was so beautiful and so relevant that it had to be told. So we don't have a lot to clarify here. It shows what I'm seeing. And I am going to clarify, it's very important to stay for the clarification because we have some very important cards to clarify, though not many of them. So we need to know the High Priestess, we need to know the future, we need to know the actual actions, we need to know what your person, what this energy is between the two of you that seems to be muddy, not very clear, poses a little bit of risk to the relationship, I believe. And we're going to get the oracle energy advice from the cards, the animal spirit cards. So why is this divine love? The Naked Heart is divine love. There's no other tarot deck that has this as a major arcana, the highest level major arcana in every other deck that I own, that I've seen so far, indicates that the World card is the final conclusion. What this says is that the final conclusion in your lives, in your love, is that you will be a legacy to one another in love, that you will always be a divine person in this person's life. You knew that going into the relationship. You know it now. Now the only question is, what are you going to do about it? Because right now you are not in a sacred union. You have no cards of union here yet. All right, so the Heart of Cups indicates that this is a more lightweight relationship because there is a third-party interest. There's a third-party situation. In other words, your attentions are not solely on this person. You have other responsibilities and obligations. It shows the Three of Cups, which also indicates that your person is dealing with a very dramatic situation in another relationship. A significant other with whom they have responsibility. Doesn't really show marriage, but you know, it's definitely a marriage-like responsibility. And why is the Tower card here? Well, this person wants equal give and take, and they don't have it with this other person that feels like your competition, Virgo, or vice versa. So this energy can be totally swapped in terms of roles, okay? So you swap it accordingly because this is a flow of energy. It's like an electrical current. Okay, it shows that your person is very confined, feels very restricted, feels imprisoned by this third-party situation. This person is trying to build a future and yet feels caught in their own web. It shows that there are children involved, and it also shows that your person, Virgo, or you, are in a situation that you'll break your own heart if you let the people you love down. All right. So what is your future with, what is your person, how does your person see the future with you, Virgo? How does your person see the future? Well, the Seven of Wands, they're willing to fight for it. They're willing to defend it. They're willing to fight, defend. It does show, however, the Moon card again. Your person does not know if you even want a future with them. You have held things so close to the vest. The High Priestess, right? The High Priestess is a keeper of secrets, totally discreet. Though you love, you're not talking about that love. And it's next to the King of Cups, which is a person who loves people so deeply but usually doesn't say it. You're coming in here with Emperor energy. You're sort of being an enforcer of the status quo. It shows that, according to this, the King of Pentacles has goals, places to go, people to see, things to do. You do, Virgo, have a very, very strong plan, and it is to ultimately protect a child. It's ultimately to make your person an offer of love that's quite substantial, up to and including marriage. It shows that you have to be very stealthy in how this is done, and it shows that you have the strength. And part of what your belief system is, Virgo, is that if it's meant to be, it'll be, and this person, it'll all work out timing wise. So you have this sort of incredible faith in God, the universe, your spirit, your intuition, that says, I'm going to love this person forever, so what happens on the calendar is not so much my concern. Okay, your person, the clarification card here on the High Priestess is that at some time in your relationship, you've been really hurt by this person. It shows the Five of Swords. They didn't really accept your love at a very, very delicate time when you were first revealing it. So you went into hiding. You hid that love because you didn't want to be hurt. So your person said something about this third party situation, indicating that it wasn't very tolerable, that they couldn't really stay here. This wasn't, they love you, no matter how much they love you, they have to live their life and be fulfilling. And it shows that that was not something you thought would happen. You somehow had this sort of very, I think, naive and innocent thought that love is love and love conquers all, very kind of a Walt Disney version, a Disney Channel version of what love is. And so it does indicate that there could also be an age difference. The person that you love, Virgo, could be much wiser or older than you. Not too much though, there's only probably a few years difference, but here we go. The Ace of Cups. You have also, you love this person again. So it does show that you know your person loves you, you love your person. It shows that you also think that your person has a lot of opportunities to go elsewhere. It shows that you are fearful that your person may have somebody else that they're interested in. And it shows that your person also has children. Interesting that you're, why is Virgo very concerned, or why is Virgo's person very concerned about children? Why? Oh, the Mother of Cups. Oh, well, they want you to do the right thing by your children, Virgo. So the person that you love is a divine counterpart. They love you with all their heart. Okay, so Virgo, your person here feels loved by you, but you don't speak about it. Please clarify the King of Cups card, the Spirit of Cups. Why is the Spirit of Cups card here for Virgo's reading in terms of how their person sees a future with them? Justice card, okay. Lover's card, wow. The Justice card is all about balance, but it's also about legal paperwork. It also indicates that your person of interest wants you to be divorced. They want you to be single. They want you to be available to them. They want to fly through life with you. Look at that, lifelong partners. You are in a divine partnership, Virgo. Divine partnership, divine partnership, divine partner energy. Divine partner energy. This has the eternity symbol. Look at that. All right. So why is the Moon card here that's hidden? Oh, you are one another's rock star. This is hopes and dreams for love coming true on a spiritual basis. You communicate without communicating. You communicate telepathically. See this sort of energy field here? That's sort of like a sonar sending out signals of attraction and love. It also shows that, you know, when the two of you aren't around, you have this Piscean ability to, you connect. You're connecting at a spiritual level in the 5D. But I would also say it's telepathic. See this? You have telepathic communication with this person. So you don't really understand why it would be so important for you to verbalize this feeling that you have about them. They feel as though they don't have to tell you, you don't have to tell them. However, it is disrupting the stability. So both of you need to come clean. So the tarot is advising for this coming week to be very stable, very loving, but you need to take that step forward. You need to move forward. You know, your fear is that somehow by telling the person it will spoil the situation. And that is incorrect information. Okay, so why is that Four of Cups here? Yeah, see, here we have the Empress. All right, divine feminine partnership. It shows that you need to make plans to leave this toxic situation and that's the underlying fear. It shows a Death card. You need to make a plan. So it's okay. So basically, the Tarot is telling you that you're going to poison this relationship. This relationship will fail within 4 months if you do not share with this person that you really love them, share that you have a plan of action, because both of you are too spiritual and you're too kind, you're too loving to hurt each other by staying in toxicity. It's not how you're cut. It's not how your person's cut. It shows that you would rather call an ending to the relationship officially than for it to die a death of just being frozen out. The Empress card, the Emperor card, again, divine relationship. The weekend's with lovemaking. So why is that lovemaking card here? That is Foxy finding time to have time with each other, to slip out the back, Jack, make a new plan, Stan. Wheel of Fortune, hop on, hop off. You are going to have a very brief window of opportunity. If you let it pass, it will fall apart. But again, all is not lost because you both love each other. You'll just keep trying till it works. So Virgo, we're going to look at the Spirit Oracle cards for you. How should you approach your relationship? It does show that the High Priestess, you need to share more in terms of your feelings, what you want, your plans, how you would like to resolve the relationship with your other situation. Okay. Virgo, embrace your lover with the Bat Spirit. Rebirth is assured. You need to tell your partner the Death card, which is right here. That is the advice from the Tarot also, is to tell your partner that you will have a time. You will come into alignment again with being able to spend time together and move forward in your lives together. Reclaim your power, Virgo. Don't let the situation, don't let old hurts and old wounds rule the day now. And it says, watch and wait, you know. Don't be so sure that your person is dating other people. Don't be so insecure. It just says, you know, that divine, there is a divine love here. Dream the world into being. You have every power to manifest. You are part of the magician crew. You can manifest anything you want, Virgo. You've done it in every other realm of your life. You can now do it in love. That is your reading, Virgo. If you like it, please subscribe, like, share, comment, and thank you for watching. Thank you for all of your support, and I will talk to you soon. We have a lot of readings coming out this week for the month of January. All right, Virgo, have a good one. Bye-bye.